In this video, we will show you how to introduce video transitions into your mix. Firstly, let's show you how to introduce a video transition between two videos or photos, which are crossfaded. When videos and photos are crossfaded, you'll notice the white crossfade box. To introduce a transition, right-click on the crossfade box and select Insert Transition. Here I'll select Standard Wipes from the drop-down menu. You'll notice the crossfade box has now changed, indicating a transition has now been introduced and has replaced the crossfade. You can adjust the length of the transition by moving your cursor to the start or end of the transition, and when the adjust length indicators appear, click and hold the left mouse button and drag accordingly. You can also alter the properties of the transition by right-clicking on it and selecting Transition Properties. The parameters of the transition will appear. You can change these parameters to create unique and interesting transitions. To remove the transition, right-click on it and select Remove Transition. You can also insert transitions between segments on different tracks. The transition will come into effect when the next segment is introduced into the timeline. To introduce the transition, right-click in the area you wish the transition to be placed and select Video Transition. Here I'll select Stretch. A red transition box will appear, indicating a transition has been placed on the track. You can access the properties easily by clicking on the properties icon within the transitions grid. The properties will appear and you can alter them as you please. Then click OK. Like with effects, you can adjust the length of the transition using the adjust length indicators. When adjusting the length, you'll notice the transition will snap to the beginning of the segment and snap to the segment above or below it, depending on where the segment is situated. This is very helpful for positioning your transition correctly. You can also expand or decrease the size of the transition grid using the Expand Decrease icon. You are also able to add multiple transitions to the same area, giving you the flexibility to blend numerous transitions. Like with video effects, multiple transitions in the same area work on the priority system and can be moved to different areas on the track. This is a cool way of creating new and unique transitions by blending two or more existing transitions together. As mentioned previously, the transitions work on a priority system, meaning the transition in the top priority position will take precedence over the transitions underneath. Here I have the iris transition in priority 1 and the slide transition in priority position 3. If I move the scroll bar to view the transition, I can see the two transitions blending in a certain way. However, if I move the iris transition to priority 2 and move the slide transition to priority 1, you will notice the transition has changed. As shown, you can easily move the transition to change its priority position. Or else, you can right-click on the transition, go to Transition Priority, and select from 1 to 5 to place it in its new priority position. These transitions can also be grouped to the segment using the Auto Selection and Grouping tools. This means the transition will always remain with the segment, allowing you to move it anywhere within the mixing screen. You can also copy and paste a transition by selecting it, right-clicking on it, and selecting Copy Transition. Then simply right-click in the area you wish to paste and select Paste. You can also mute a transition by right-clicking on it and selecting Mute Transition. To unmute the transition, simply right-click it on again and uncheck Mute Transition. To delete a transition, select it, right-click, and select Delete Transition.